Okay, welcome students. We are today going to take accountancy chapter number 4. What is chapter number 4? Reconstruction of partnership. Friends, as I told you in the previous lectures that our entire Part 1 of accountancy in standard 12th is about partnership. Formation of a partnership, admission of a partnership, retirement or death of a partner, as well as dissolution of partnership. So today we are going to learn the basics from that. Reconstruction of partnership. The word reconstruction says that already which was previously constructed and we are going to now revise it, change it. So what we are going to change in partnership? Few topics I will be listing on the board. The first topic of today, change in profit loss ratio of partners. This is the first topic we are going to learn in the reconstruction of partnership. What is that? Change in profit loss ratio of partners. And second important thing, what we are going to learn in this topic is change in values of assets and liabilities. So friends, we'll begin with change in profit loss ratio of partners. It is a very simple mathematics what we are going to learn in this. First example I like to put it, that in a partnership firm, there were three partners, say A, B and C. When they started their partnership firm, they had decided to share their profit and loss in the ratio of, say, 1:2:3. Initially, when they started the partnership firm, they had decided that they will share their profit in the proportion of 1:2:3, that is 1/6, 2/6, 3/6. Now every one of you knows how this 6 is derived, that is 1+2+3=6. Gradually, after few years, they decided, A, B and C jointly together decided to change this profit loss ratio 1:2:3 to some new ratio. Let's say 2:1:3. See, A, B, C. In the old, A was getting 1/6th part. B was getting 2/6th part and C was getting 3/6th part. Now this was their old ratio and this is their new ratio. What happens in the new ratio? 2/6, 1/6, 3/6. Old ratio, new ratio. Now let us find out, by changing this ratio, who is at loss and who is at gain? That means who has given the sacrifice and who has obtained the benefit, that is gain. Sacrifice meaning is very simple and gain meaning is also very simple. Here I can see that in the old ratio, A was getting one portion out of total 6 portion. Let us understand it with the help of a diagram. Suppose This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 parts of the total profit. According to the old ratio, A was getting 1 part. See, this much part was obtained by A. This is for A. Now, same 6 parts, I am going to do it here for the new ratio. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In the new ratio, A is getting 2 upon 6. That means 2 parts out of 6 parts. So, this much is obtained by A. So, mathematics, I am going to do it. But with a diagram, with the help of a diagram, it is still easier for you to understand. In old, A was getting 1 part. In new, A is getting 2 parts. So that is a gain what A is getting. By the change in profit and loss, A has got change towards benefit. Now, with this blue color chalk, I am going to make you understand about the old ratio of B. In this old ratio, B was getting 2 parts out of 6. So, let's say these 2 parts. This was the profit enjoyed by B. But according to the new ratio, B is getting only 1 part out of total 6 parts. So now you can easily understand that partner B in old was getting 2 parts out of 6. Now in the new is getting only 1 part out of 6. So he has sacrificed his 1 part out of 6. Previously he was getting 2. Now in the new out of 6 he is getting only 1. So B has sacrificed, A has gained. What is the situation of C? In the old, C was getting 3 parts out of 6. In the new, he is getting 3 parts out of 6. So you can see that partner C is neither sacrificing, neither gaining. He was getting 3 parts out of 6 according to the old arrangement, and he is also getting 3 parts according to the new arrangement. So, Mr. C or the partner C is neither gaining, neither sacrificing. This was a simple way of explanation because the denominators 1 is to 2 is to 3, that is 1 plus 2 plus 3 is equal to 6. Here 2 plus 1 plus 3, that is equal to 6. I have kept denominators equal in both the situation, old and new. But it is not always possible or it is not always required. So there are ways of the doing sum where these denominators will be different. Let us do that kind of the sum also. Say there were 3 partners X, Y and Z. They were sharing their profit and loss in the proportion of 2 is to 2 is to 1. Now 2 is to 2 is to 1, that means 2 upon 5, 2 upon 5 and 1 upon 5. This was their old arrangement. Suppose they decided the new ratio X, Y, Z as 3 is to 2 is to 1. So now friends, here in the new arrangement, the denominator will change. According to the old, it was 2 plus 2 plus 1, that is equal to 5. This was old arrangement. And this one is new arrangement. And it is 3 upon 6, 2 upon 6, 1 upon 6. So now, this one is not as simple as previous one. we will have to apply mathematics over here. What is the mathematics? Suppose I am writing sacrifice ratio. Now, to find the sacrifice ratio, there is a formula given in the textbook, that is old ratio minus new ratio. OR, that stands for the old ratio, minus new ratio. Let's do it for the first partner, X. What is the old ratio of X? 2 upon 5. Minus, what is the new ratio? You can see 3 upon 6. Now friend, this kind of solution we have done in lower standards. But suppose we are facing a problem in finding out LCM, let's avoid that method. Let us go by a simple version. What is the simple version? I am going to multiply these two denominators. 5 multiplied by 6. Starting from the denominator of the right hand side, 6 2's are 12. Minus 5 multiplied by 3. So this will be 12 minus 5 3's are 15 upon 5 multiplied by 6, 30. So my answer is minus 3 upon 30. So friends, when I am adopting the formula of sacrifice ratio and when I get a negative answer like this, it is not a sacrifice, it is a gain. What could be interpreted with this? That X has gained. What we did with the X, same we are going to repeat with the Y. So again the same formula, old ratio minus new ratio. What is the old ratio for partner Y? That you can see it here, 2 upon 5. So let us write 2 upon 5. What is the new ratio? 2 upon 6. We go by simple method. We are multiplying these two denominators, 5 multiplied by 6. Cross multiplication, 6 multiplied by 2, bracket, minus 5 multiplied by 2. So 6 2's are 12, minus 5 2's are 10 upon 30. That gives us 2 upon 30. Here we have adopted the formula of sacrifice ratio. We are getting answer in positive. So it is a sacrifice. Sacrifice given by Y is 2 upon 30. Gain for X is minus 3 upon 30. Let us go for Z. Same formula friends, old ratio minus new ratio. What is the old ratio for Z? 1 upon 5. What is the new ratio? 1 upon 6. Multiplying two denominators, now I am directly writing the answer. These two denominators I am multiplying, 5 multiplied by 6, 30. Cross multiplication, 6 multiplied by 1, 6 minus 5 multiplied by 1, 5, 1 upon 30. We have adopted the formula of sacrifice ratio. We are getting the answer in addition, that is positive answer we are getting, 1 upon 30. So it is sacrifice by Z. If we want to just summarize this question, we can easily understand that 2 portion out of 30 and 1 portion out of 30 respectively are sacrificed by Y and Z. Y is sacrificing 2 portion out of 30, Z is sacrificing 1 portion out of 30. If Y and Z are sacrificing, obviously, who is benefited? X. X is getting the 2 shares out of 30 from Y, 1 share out of 30 from Z. and he is getting 3 out of 30 as a benefit. So this is the formula of sacrifice ratio. What is the formula for the sacrifice ratio, friends? Sacrifice ratio formula is very simple. Old ratio minus new ratio. And how to do the mathematics that I have taught you? You have to simply multiply 2 denominators and then you can do the cross multiplication. 6 multiply by 2, 5 multiply by 3. The cross multiplication will start from right hand side denominator to the left hand side numerator. 6 into 2, that is this, minus left hand side denominator with the right hand side numerator. 5 multiply by 3, and so it goes on. So this was the formula of sacrifice ratio. Now there is a question, what is sacrifice? Now in your textbook it has been clearly mentioned in the bold letters that whatever portion of profit an existing partner forgoes, मतलब अपने प्रॉफिट के हिस्से में से जो प्रॉफिट अब नया पार्टनर या पुराना पार्टनर लेट गो कर रहा है, यानी ही इज गिविंग द सेक्रीफाइस फ्रॉम हिज शेयर कंपेयर टू द ओल्ड, दैट इज नोन एज सेक्रीफाइस रेशियो. ऑलरेडी द फॉर्मूला इज गिवन इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक, यू कैन इजीली रिमेंबर दैट फॉर्मूला. नाउ आई एम गोइंग फॉर द सम्स रिलेटेड टू द गेन रेशियो. The formula for gain ratio will utilize same 2 components, but only the thing will be, orders will be changed. Sacrifice ratio, old ratio minus new ratio. In gain ratio, new ratio minus old ratio. That will be your formula. Let us do it. We will be taking one more example to find out the gain ratio. Now understand, friend, that when in sacrifice ratio, we are getting answers in negative, we treat it as a gain. So if in the gain ratio, if we get answers negative, it will be treated as a sacrifice. Opposite ho jata hai. Agar sacrifice mein aapko minus mein answer mil raha hai, to iska meaning gain hota hai. Aur gain ratio mein agar minus mein answer mil raha hai, to uska meaning hota hai sacrifice. Say for example, there were 3 partners L, M, N. And their old ratio was say 3:2. So that means 3/8, 3/8, 2/8. And they have decided to change their profit loss ratio as a new ratio. Let's say 2:2, 2:1. This is their new ratio, resulting into 2/5, 2/5, 1/5. Now, as I told you, we are going to learn about gain ratio. I'll be finding out gain ratio for all the 3 partners L, M, N, utilizing the same formula, gain ratio. What will be the formula of gain ratio? New ratio minus old ratio for all the 3 partners. Let's do it for L, the first one. Yes, new ratio. What is the new ratio of L? The new ratio of L is 2/5. So I'm writing 2/5 minus old ratio. What is the old ratio of L? 3/8. Therefore, these 2 denominators are multiplied. 5 8's are 40. 8 2's are 16, minus 5 3's are 15, 1/40. Answer is in positive and we have adopted the formula of gain ratio. Gain ratio ka formula hai, answer positive mein aa raha hai, so that is gain. Now I am going to do it for partner M. Again, the same formula, new ratio minus old ratio. The new ratio for M is 2/5. Old ratio of M, 3/8. So you can say it will be the same situation. Therefore, 5s are 40, 8 2s are 16 minus 15. Therefore, again 1 upon 40. And in the gain ratio, answer is in positive. So it will be treated as a gain. Now, we are going for partner N. New ratio minus old ratio. New ratio for N is 1 upon 5. Old ratio is 2 upon 8. So 1 upon 5 minus 2 upon 8. Therefore, 5 multiplied by 8, 40. 8 ones are 8. 5 twos are 10. 8 minus 10 is minus 2. Minus 2 upon 40. We have adopted the formula of gain ratio, but we are getting the answer in negative. So that negative will be treated as sacrifice. So friends, easily you can tally your sum. 1 upon 40 gain, 1 upon 40 gain. So that makes total gain 2 upon 40. Samne N is sacrificing 2 upon 40. So now it means that N has sacrificed 1 upon 40 in the favor of L, and N has also sacrificed 1 upon 40 in the favor of M. For L it is gain, for M it is gain, but for N it is sacrifice. Right, students? So these were the basics. What? Sacrifice ratio, gain ratio. Even the definition of the gain ratio is available in your textbook. As a MCQs, 1 mark, section B, it is asked. Write the definition of sacrifice ratio, or write definition of gain ratio, write the formula of sacrifice ratio, or write the formula of gain ratio. You can easily find it from your textbook. And as for examples, I have done it on the board, so it makes easy for you to understand. Now, as I told you that there are two topics in reconstruction of partnership. One is change in profit loss ratio of partners. Second one is change in value of asset and liabilities. These two topics. Question arises that why we want to reconstruct a partnership form. Already terms and conditions were decided when the partnership form was formed. See friends, in this world changes take place. Maybe it is an environment, maybe it is a social life, history or other topics. Same way in accountancy, changes can take place. When these partners had decided to start a business, they had formed a partnership firm. Us time ke situation mein, har ek partner, each and every partner's role was different. Kuch samay ke baad shayad unke roles different ho jate, unki mehnat alag ho jati hai, unka involvement business mein jyada kam ho sakta hai. And according to that, the profit loss ratio can also be changed. So, what are the situations when we change profit and loss ratio? The first situation is when a new partner is admitted. Second situation is when an existing partner retires or an existing partner is dead. So, ye kuch circumstances hote when you are required to reconstruct the partnership formulas. One, change in profit and loss ratio of partner. Second, change in value of assets and liabilities. Now, this change in values of asset and liabilities is important for lesson number 4, lesson number 5 and lesson number 6. Whenever there will be change in value of assets and liabilities, as per the normal rules of accountancy, there could be loss or there could be gain. That things I am going to write it on the board, that how it is going to affect the partners or their profit or their loss when there is change in value of assets and liabilities. Let us write what kind of effects will be given in the books of account when we change the values of asset and liabilities.
First of all, students, whenever there is a change in value of asset and liabilities, it is recorded in an account known as revaluation account. The name of that particular account is revaluation account. How do a revaluation account looks like? Revaluation account looks exactly like your profit and loss account of standard 11th, or you can say trading account. I am first of all going to draw the specimen of revaluation account. Debit, credit, particulars, amount, again particulars, amount. This is the format of your revaluation account. Very easy, students. In a very less time, you will be very acquainted with this revaluation account. Okay. When value of an asset increases, credit of revaluation account. See, when a value of an asset increases, it is to be credited in the revaluation account, because whenever the value of asset increases, it is one kind of a gain to the firm. If a partnership firm is having land and building of rupees 1 lakh, and over a period of time, the valuation of that land and building is 1,50,000. So that additional 50,000, the new value is 1,50,000, old value was 1 lakh. So additional 50,000, increased 50,000 will be credited in revaluation account. Why credited? All gains are credited, all incomes are credited. That is a basic rule we learnt in standard 11th. Whenever the value of asset increases, it is a gain. It is one kind of a benefit to the partnership firm, and therefore it is credited in revaluation account. But what value? Only the difference value. Say for example, old value of land and building is equal to 1 lakh rupees. Old value of land and building is equal to 1 lakh rupees. Now I am going to put the new value over here. As an adjustment, suppose the new value is given as rupees 1,50,000. Comparing the old value with the new value, we find that there is increase in the value of asset. How much increase? 50,000. So what shall I write in the revaluation? I shall write by land and building account, outer column, 50,000. So this is accounting treatment for change in value of asset, but change in value of asset by the way of increase. Same way, I am going to explain you about the value of asset when it decreases. Okay, let's say old value of furniture was rupees 20,000 and the new value of furniture is rupees 15,000. You can see over here that the old value of furniture is 20,000. New value was decided as 15,000. So we have decreased the value of furniture. Furniture is an asset. When the value of asset decreases, it is one kind of a loss, and all losses are always debited. Here we are going to debit
to furniture account 5000. Old value 20,000, new value 15,000. So the value of furniture has decreased by 5,000. And because it has been decreased in the value of asset, it is one kind of a loss, and therefore we have debited it. Now this both accounting treatment, I have given it in the revaluation account. But friends, if I want to pass journal entries, what it could be? First of all, if I want to pass the journal entry of this, it is very simple. Land and building account debited to revaluation account. Because there is increase in the value of asset, that particular asset has to be debited. Here it is land and building. So we have debiting land and building to revaluation account. Journal entry will be land and building account debited to revaluation account 50,000, been increase in the value of land and building. Now journal entry for this. When the value of asset decreases, revaluation account debited to furniture account 5,000, been decrease in the value of asset. So right now on the board what you see is two different things. One, increase in the value of asset. Number two, decrease in the value of asset. When the value of asset increases, in the revaluation account, it is credited. When the value of asset decreases, it is debited in the revaluation account. And for the sake of journal entries, it is very easy. When the value of asset increases, yahan par jaise ye value of asset increase hua hai, to land and building account debited to revaluation account, been increase in the value of land and building. And when asset like furniture value decreases, revaluation account debited to furniture account. So journal entry for this assets. There are various other assets also, which I am going to put on the board. Rent receivable ₹500. Anything which is receivable is your income. All incomes are credited. So I am going to put it over here. My rent receivable ₹500. This is an asset, and rent receivable income credited to the revaluation account. Prepaid insurance premium ₹200. Any expenditure which are paid in advance, they are known as prepaid. Normally in standard 11, while solving the sums of annual accounts, that is final accounts, prepaid insurance premium was subtracted on the debit side of profit and loss account. As we do not have here the profit and loss account, we only have the revaluation account, prepaid insurance premium will be credited in revaluation account. When I say that prepaid insurance premium is credited in the revaluation account, it is something like what we did in standard 11, subtracting prepaid insurance premium from the insurance premium debit side of profit and loss account. So here we do not have profit and loss account, hence we are putting here on the credit side. Buy prepaid insurance premium. ₹200. This it is. So we have done few assets, land and building,
value increased, furniture value decreased, and expenditure or income related adjustments like rent receivable 500, that is again an asset, we have credited it. Prepaid insurance premium, that is again one kind of an expenditure paid in advance resulting to be an asset, so I have put it on the credit side. Now regarding assets we have learnt, suppose I want to pass the journal entry for this, it is like rent receivable account debited to revaluation account, rupees 500. Prepaid insurance premium account debited to revaluation account, bin prepaid insurance premium. Now, I will teach you about the change in the value of liabilities. Right? We have learnt the change in the value of asset. Students, I am very sure that you are very clever to understand this thing, vice versa. Just imagine, when the value of asset increases, we put it on the credit side. So now, liabilities will be exactly opposite. When the values of liability will increase, we will debit them in revaluation account. And when the value of liability will decrease, we will credit them in revaluation account. So, accounting treatment of asset, whatever you have learnt, exactly the opposite effects for the liabilities will be given in the revaluation account. Let us learn that. For that, I'll have to erase the board and then I will show you what are the effects of liabilities. So, start with you. Okay, students, revaluation account once again. Now, friends, revaluation account we are going to learn in reference of changes in the value of liabilities. How the change in the value of liabilities will be recorded in revaluation account. We have already learned about assets. Let us say, creditors. You know creditors are liabilities. Old value, rupees 30,000. Old value of creditor is 30,000. New value, rupees 27,000. Old value is 30,000 and new value is 27,000. So it means that there is decrease in the value of creditors. Creditors are liabilities. When liability decreases, it is one kind of a gain, benefit. Normal rules of accountancy. All gains, incomes are always credited. So friends, how much is the gain over here? 3,000. Old value 30,000, new value 27,000. Difference between 30,000, 27,000 is 3,000. By creditors 3,000, because the value of liability has decreased. I have credited it. Opposite to the things what we did in asset. Asset maker value decrease hoga, we will debit it. But if the value of liability decreases, we credit it. Now regarding outstanding salary. Outstanding salary of rupees 1500. Outstanding salary, salary due but not paid. Jo salary due ho chuka hai and we have not paid it. That is known as a outstanding salary. Again, outstanding salary is a liability. Increase hua liability mein, salary due tha, pay nahi kiya, there is an increase in liability. So I am going to debit it in the revaluation account. Okay. Now this was effects in revaluation account. By the way of journal entries, very simple. Over here, creditors, the value has decreased. So, creditors account debited to revaluation account. इसके बारे में जर्नल एंट्री लिखने के लिए व्हाट शैल आई डू, क्रेडिटर्स अकाउंट डेबिटेड 3000 टू रिवैल्यूएशन अकाउंट 3000 एंड फॉर दिस रिवैल्यूएशन अकाउंट डेबिटेड टू आउटस्टैंडिंग सैलरी 1500. सो वेरी इजी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ जर्नल एंट्री आल्सो. वंस यू पुट इट इन रिवैल्यूएशन अकाउंट, ऑल द एंट्रीज वेदर इट इज अबाउट एसेट और लायबिलिटीज व्हिच आर पुट ऑन द क्रेडिट साइड in the journal entries they will be debited and revaluation account itself will be credited. Jaise ki yahan par hai, creditors account debited to revaluation account and for year revaluation account debited to outstanding salary. Right students, let us think about some one or two more liabilities. Provident fund. Old value of the provident fund. ₹40,000. New value. ₹50,000. Friends, provident fund is a liability. Old value is 40,000. You can see it over here. And the new value is 50,000. What does that show? That shows clear indication that there is increase in the value of provident fund. What is the increase value? 10,000. Yeah, so that we are going to debit it here to provident fund 10,000. One more important thing. Whatever values we put in the revaluation account are the difference between the old value and new value. Most of the times students make an error that instead of putting the difference between the old value and the new value, students simply keep the new values by mistake in the revaluation account. That is wrong. Be aware, be clear in your concept that in revaluation account we are going to keep only the difference value. Difference between the old value and new value. Now friend, once the revaluation account is prepared, just as we were finding out like gross profit or gross loss in trading account or net profit or net loss in the profit and loss account, over here also we are going to apply the same technique. We are going to find out either revaluation profit or revaluation loss. When debit side total exceeds the credit side total, yani ki ye debit ka total agar credit side ke total se zyada hai, as for example this, yahan par aap dekh rahe, the debit total of revaluation account is say 11,500. Credit side total is only 3000. So difference between 11,500 and 3000 is 8,500. And this will be treated as by revaluation loss. This is revaluation loss because debit side total exceeds the credit side total. Debit side ka total compared to credit side is more. See here, the total of debit side was 11,500 while the total on the credit side is only 3000. So difference between them is 8,500 and that is revaluation loss. The opposite could also happen, friends. When credit side total exceeds the debit side total, there will be revaluation profit. And ultimately, this revaluation profit or revaluation loss will be distributed among the partners in their old profit sharing ratio. Again, friends, I will repeat, revaluation profit or revaluation loss, either of them will be distributed among the partners in old profit loss sharing ratio. So, two things over here, change in profit and loss ratio of partners, change in value of asset and liabilities. Change in profit and loss ratio, we have understood, old ratio, new ratio. Sacrifice ratio is equal to old ratio minus new ratio. Gain ratio is equal to new ratio minus old ratio. That was with the first part. Then we came across change in the value of asset and liabilities. Now this change in the value of asset and liabilities are to be reflected, are to be recorded in a particular account which is known as a revaluation account. वो account उसी लिए बनाया गया है to revalue the asset and liabilities. And what is the outcome of the revaluation account? By preparing revaluation account, we get either revaluation profit or revaluation loss, whatever it might be, revaluation profit or revaluation loss, but that is distributed among the partners in the old profit sharing ratio, profit loss sharing ratio. Now, after this 2 point, I am adding one third number point, friends. Accounting treatment of two things. One, accumulated profits, and number two, accumulated losses. Accumulated profits are also categorized as reserves and surpluses. Accumulated losses and accumulated profits, how to distribute them and what accounting treatments are to be given to the accumulated profits and what are accumulated profits, how accumulated losses are to be treated in accountancy and which kind of accumulated losses are there. These two topics we will be answering in the next session. So, till then, you have to revise the formula of sacrifice ratio and the definition of sacrifice ratio, formula for the gain ratio and the definition of gain ratio, as well as few examples from your textbook regarding revaluation account. How to prepare the revaluation account, what accounting treatments are given in the revaluation account, and journal entries related to the revaluation account. Next lecture, in the next lecture, I will be giving you the details about the accumulated profits and its journal entries. I'll be giving you the examples of accumulated losses and how to treat it in account. That also I will teach you. So till then, be safe, take care, be at home. Bye-bye.